Picture the Nevada landscape. Barren desert, sandy dunes, or maybe sun-blasted rocks scorching under a cloudless sky. Now, add to that image, in the earth below, the fiery sunset pink of a desert rose. There's life out here, and a lot of it is green.
There is a misperception that Nevada is just a desert. You can't plant anything, you can't make it look good. Well, at the University of Nevada Cooperative Extension, they are on a mission to shatter that myth.
The UNR Cooperative Extension has been serving the area for over 100 years and owes its founding to the Morrill Act of 1862, signed into law by President Lincoln.
Angela, hi.
Hey, Sean, how are you doing?
I am doing great. I'm so excited about being here. I'm just so into all this right now.
Oh, I'm glad to hear that.
Meeting somebody like you just makes my day. Tell me more about where I am in this center.
Okay, this is the University of Nevada Cooperative Extension site. And Cooperative Extension is a college in the College of Ag of UNR. We teach people who otherwise would not have access to university research-based information. People can come here, listen to us, get free fact sheets, and know that we're not going to try to sell them anything.
So you're doing more than just making yards and the desert look good.
We have so many programs. Well, first, we have three divisions. We have health and nutrition, which works with nutrients and dining, and there's a lot of dietitians there. Then there's children, youth, and families, and that's where 4-H is. And then there's water, horticulture, and natural resources. So we do, in my team, master gardeners. We have 250 certified master gardeners.
The master gardeners are volunteers, community members dedicated to guiding local gardeners and passing along their wisdom. The extension welcomes school classrooms, visitors from rest homes, and all walks of life in between.
Angela, I am shocked by the energy of this place and all the things that are going on. It's incredible.
Right now, what we have is a field trip with children from Stuckey Elementary School, and they are taking this field trip learning about balance of nutrients in the desert, balance of water, looking at the soil that we really must have, and then looking at the difference between being a pollinator and being a pest.
And not one of them is bored. They're all having a blast.
Oh, heck yeah.
Hey, tell me about, what is this here?
Okay, well, this is our youth horticulture garden. All the material in here was donated. It was built by volunteers.
What's in there?
Well, right now, there's a lot of members of the cabbage family. So that's broccoli, cabbage, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, turnips, and so forth.
Take a lot of water?
Not so much. They take, more water than a cactus, certainly, but not as much as some other things do. You know, we advise people not to grow celery here, because celery just takes an enormous amount of water, and it never looks as good as the stuff you can get at the store.
How do you keep the rabbits out? Well, I guess you got a fence here, yeah?
Well, we have a fence as if the rabbits paid attention to that. What we do when we first plant things is we put a layer of what's called floating row cover. And the idea is rabbits, as a rule, will not eat what rabbits cannot see.
Beautiful.
The beauty of the desert springs up in these grounds, sometimes unexpectedly, in the form of agave, milkweed, and flowers like the desert bell. Perennial plants are grown here as well, all with techniques centered around one key word, natural.
If a plant is a perennial, it means that it can flower and produce fruits of some sort or other over several years. Seeds drop, and the parent plant continues. So you get parent plant plus its offspring. And so that can go on for years, as opposed to an annual, which, hey, you plant it this year, it's gonna flower this year, it's gonna die
this
year.
That's what you get. Talk to me about mulch and compost and how all that plays.
Okay, well, mulch is simply something that you lay on the top of the soil. And think about insulation in your roof. It helps to hold the cool in the summer and the heat in the winter. Well, that's the same thing that mulch does, but it also helps moisture and it also keeps down weed seeds. So it serves a lot of purposes. But then compost is something else. Compost is the finished product of decomposition of vegetable material. And when I say vegetable, I mean green material. You know, potato peels, apple cores, you know what I'm talking about. We put that in and we cook it. And in fact, what the things we have in the back here is a demonstration of about 5 different types of composters.
What about all natural, you use pesticides here? How does it work?
Well, we don't use pesticides here. We try very hard to use what are called cultural practices. So we try to keep the plants from experiencing real drought stress by amending the soil and putting mulch down.
So when it comes to pesticides, and obviously you don't use them, everything's natural, what are some things you can use on your plants?
Soap and water.
Really?
Uh-huh. I want to be able to feel comfortable if my children, my grandchildren were eating this.
The UNR Cooperative Extension is a place of learning, conservation, and science. But it's also a place where beauty survives, even in the harshest of environments.
A place as beautiful and as special as this wouldn't be complete without a rose garden.
How fortunate for us that we have one. And we are sitting in the middle of it. We have, I don't know, 20 or 30 different varieties of roses, and they are just so gorgeous. They don't have any flowers now because they've been pruned down, and you do prune them so that they will flower more abundantly come
late
spring.
People don't think of roses
in the desert.
Yeah.
You know, roses are so hardy, and if you amend your soil with compost and you make sure that it's kept evenly moist, not wet, and you have a layer of mulch over it, well, what you're doing is protecting it from excess heat, because it's that root system that we never think about, but we really must.
Now, there is so much going on here. It bends the mind. Let's just go down a menu. I mean, you've got perennials, you've got a cactus garden, we've got the rose garden, what else?
We have the herb farm and the herb garden. We have the native plants, agaves and aloes. We have the children's gardens. We have a large palm demonstration area with many, many, many different kinds of palms. We have a couple of mini orchards.
I leave the Cooperative Extension with a sense of the higher purpose of the hands that work the soil here. With painstaking care, they've cultivated not only exquisite gardens, but a thriving community, both of which are sure to remain evergreen.